What is microsporogenesis? Divya?
Ma'am, the process of formation of microspore from pollen mother cell.
Very good. So that means the formation of microspores are called microsporogenesis, and microspores are formed from the microspore mother cell, that is also called pollen mother cell, and this pollen mother cell undergoes the meiosis cell division and it forms the microspores. Okay, now in this process, where are this process is taking place? Microsporogenesis is taking place in the anther lobes. Anther lobe is having two theca, and there are four layers. What are these four layers? Aditi?
Endothecium.
Yes. The outermost epidermis. Epidermis. Is called epidermis. After that is
endothecium.
Then
middle layers,
and then
epitome.
So we have seen in the previous portion that how microspores are formed, and these microspores, the tetrad is released, and in this tetrad the four spores, pollens are formed, and these pollens are having two cells, generative cell and vegetative cell, and in 60% of the angiosperm plants this pollen is shed at the two celled stage, and in 40% it is shed at the three celled stage. What is three celled stage? When the generative is further divided into two male gametes, that is called the three celled. Okay, now similarly, as the microspores are produced, similarly megaspores are also produced inside the female reproductive part, that is the ovary. So inside the ovary, the ovules are present, and in the embryo sac is formed, which we saw, and this process is called megasporogenesis. And in the megasporogenesis, out of the four, the meiosis results into four cells. Out of these four, one will be growing further, and three will degenerate. And only one will grow further, and that one will undergo the process of mitosis and form two nucleus. And after two nucleus, four nucleus. After four nucleus, eight nucleus.
Eight.
Yes. After eight nucleus, the cell wall will be formed, and this cell wall will form and form three antipodal cells, two synergids and one egg cell, and two polar nuclei. And this stage is called, what is this stage called? Pravita?
Ma'am, seven celled and eight nucleated cell.
Very good. So this stage is called seven celled and eight nucleated stage. Very good. At which end the antipodal cells are present? Usha? At which end of the embryo sac antipodal cells are present?
Challenger end.
Very good. Challenger end. And at which end the synergids and egg cell is present? Imani?
Microfilar end.
Micropylar end. Okay. So two ends are there, micropylar end and challenger end. So three antipodal cells are present at the challenger end, and two synergids and egg cell is present at the micropylar.
Okay.
Where is filiform apparatus present? Aditi?
Yes, ma'am.
Where is filiform apparatus present?
Ma'am, inside the synergid.
With the synergids, and what is its function? What is the function of filiform apparatus?
Ma'am, it helps to go
मैम जो मेल गैमेट होते हैं उनको अंदर जाने में हेल्प करता है.
वेरी गुड. फ्रॉम माइक्रोपिलर एंड माइक्रोपाइलर एंड द पॉलन जर्म सेल द पॉलन ट्यूब विल एंटर एंड व्हेन द पॉलन ट्यूब इज एंटरिंग इट इज एंटरिंग फ्रॉम द माइक्रोपाइलर एंड. क्लियर. सो टिल नाउ आई थिंक इट इज क्लियर. कैन वी प्रोसीड. यस और नो.
यस मैम.
रेज योर हैंड इफ यू आर रेडी टू प्रोसीड. ओके. So today, now the male gamete is ready. Male gamete is ready inside the anther lobe, and female gamete is ready inside the ovary. Clear? So now, what is the requirement for for reproduction, for sexual reproduction? There should be fusion of gamete and female gamete. Now this fusion will occur only when these two will come together. But here, in case of plants, both are non-motile. The pollen is also non-motile and the egg is also non-motile. So though the egg cannot go to the pollen cannot come to the egg. So what is the requirement? The requirement is there should be some agent which can take the pollen from anther lobe to the stigma of the female reproductive part, that is pistil. So that process is called pollination. What is pollination? Pollination is the transfer of pollen from anther lobe to the stigma. That process is called pollination. And pollination is must for the fertilization, because the fusion of male and female gamete will take place only when they are in close proximity with each other. Then only it can happen. So this can happen when the pollen is near the egg. So bringing the pollen towards the female reproductive part, ovary is inside. So first of all, the pollen has to reach the stigma. Stigma is the part of the pistil which receives the pollen. And once it receives the pollen, and if the pollen is of right kind, it will not yet enter any kind of pollen. If the pollen is of the right kind, it will enter into the style and then it will reach to the ovary and ovule. Clear? So ultimately the pollen tube will germinate from the pollen and that pollen tube will enter into the ovary for the fertilization. This much is clear? There yes, are ma'am. Three types of pollination. I will share the screen with you. So pollination is of three types, major three types. Till now in lower classes, what you have studied about pollination is that pollination is of two types, self and
cross-pollination.
Cross-pollination. What is self-pollination?
The pollen grains
are transferred
on the stigma of the same flower.
Same flower. That means in your lower classes, you have studied that when the pollen and egg are of the same flower, it is called self-pollination. And when it is of the they are of the different flowers, it is called cross-pollination. But now in 12th standard, we will study further ahead, and that is pollination is of three types. One is autogamy. Now this autogamy means auto itself means self. What?
Self.
So it is self-pollination only. But here also there are two types of flowers which undergo autogamy. One are casmogamous and one are cleistogamous.
Cleistogamous.
Casmogamous flowers are exposed flowers. Exposed means in them, the anther and stigma are exposed. The flower is open and the anther and stigma are exposed. And in cleistogamous flowers, the flower is closed and the envelopes, the pistil, everything is present in the closed flower. So where are the more chances of self-pollination?
Stogamous.
Very good. Why?
And because entrance stigma lies close to each other.
And there also in casmogamous also they are lying close to each other. But what is the difference between casmogamous and clistogamous?
Ma'am, in clistogamous, the everything is in
flower. Yes, flower do not open at all.
Ma'am, the flower is closed. The flower is not closed. That means the flower is not opening. And when the flower is not opening, it means the everything is closed to the flower. So when the pollens are ready, pollens are released, the stigma's receptivity is there and the pollen will fall on the stigma and the self-pollination will automatically occur. Clear?
Yes, yes, ma'am.
Now, this clistogamous and casmogamous flowers, they are present on the same plant. Some flowers can be clistogamous and some can be casmogamous. Now, casmogamous is what? Where it is they are exposed. So they can undergo self-pollination. They can also undergo cross-pollination.
Cross-pollination.
Because they are exposed. Two things are required for pollination. One is release of the pollen and second is stigma's receptivity. The stigma should be ready to receive the pollen. When both things happen at the same time, then fertile the pollen tube can germinate on stigma. So, in casmogamous, it can be self-pollination, it can be cross-pollination because they are exposed. So, the pollen can go to different flower also, but the pollen can fall on the same stigma also. So, the chances are that it can be both. Now, I will show you the diagram where you can see this. These are the flowers. Can you see my cursor? These are the flowers which are open. They are casmogamous flowers. And these are the flowers which are closed.
Closed.
These are clistogamous flowers. Now these clistogamous flowers, the self-pollination is 100% assured. Because the pollen cannot go anywhere. The pollen has to fall on the stigma of that flower only. Whereas, in case of casmogamous flowers, there are chances that the pollen may fall on the stigma of the same flower or pollen may go to the stigma of different flowers. So, the chances are both. But in this, there is sure, there is 100% assurance that the self-pollination is going to occur. And no pollinators are required. What are pollinators?
Agents by which pollen grains can transfer from anthers to human.
Very good. So pollinators are the agents which carry pollen from one flower to another plant. Or from one plant to another plant. So they are called pollinators. In case of clistogamous plant, pollinators are not required. So this is very important 1 mark question. They will ask, what type of flowers do not require any pollinator?
Clistogamous flowers.
Clistogamous flowers produced assured seed set even in the absence of pollinators. Even in the absence of pollinators. Okay. Now tell me, is it being clistogamous is an advantage for the flower or is a disadvantage?
Disadvantage.
Why? Why disadvantage?
absence of pollinators.
So what? That is advantage. They don't require any pollinator.
Yes,
they don't require any pollinator. So this is an advantage. But yes, what is disadvantage? What is the disadvantage?
Ma'am, no chance of cross pollination.
Because it is happening in the same flower, the genetic mutation will not be there.
There, yes, ma'am.
So this happens in Chasmogamus also, because Chasmogamus is what? Chasmogamus is also on the same plant. And if in Chasmogamus the self-pollination is occurring, then there will be no genetic variation. The genetic makeup would be similar.
Yes, ma'am.
So this is the disadvantage, and the advantage is that no pollinator is required. So the second type of pollination is zitonogamy.
Zitonogamy.
Now this also occurs in the same plant, but
different
the flowers are different. Same plant, but different flowers. And here you require the pollinating agent. Pollinating agent is required because someone has to carry the pollen from one flower to another flower. So you require pollinating agents. And the new plants which are formed, they are genetically similar again. Why genetically similar?
Because on the same plant.
Because they are the same plant. So the genetic makeup is same. So here in zitonogamy also, the new plant would not be genetically similar. The new plant would be genetically similar. Clear?
Yes.
And here it requires pollinating agents, because someone has to carry pollen from one flower to another flower, but it happens on the same plant. So it is genetically similar. The third type is xenogamy. Now this xenogamy happens in different plants. That means from one plant to another
plant flower.
And here the advantage is that the new plant, the seed would be of different genetic. The variation will be there. There will be variation genetically in the new plant. That is the difference. And this is the only type of pollination where the new plant is genetically different, maybe genetically different. This is the only type of pollination which is xenogamy, where the new plant shows genetic variation, or the new plant can be genetically different, because this involves pollen of one flower plant and egg of different plant. Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Now, can you tell me which one should be the most advantageous and why?
Xenogamy. Why? Because it is genetically different.
Because it ensures genetic variation. Because it ensures genetic variation. Why it ensures genetic variation?
Because the male gamete is from one plant
and the female gamete is from another plant. So it's the true advantage of sexual reproduction. Here we are getting male gamete of one genetic makeup and female gamete of different genetic makeup, so that it ensures genetic variation in the new generation. Clear? Okay. Now, I'll ask you one question of common sense. let me see who can answer. These flowers would be of the flowers who are indulging in autogamy and monogamy. Would they be colored or would they be white? Or would they be having any fragrance, good fragrance?
Ma'am, in autogamy, the cluster monogamy.
Let me ask some other person also. Yes, Usha, Aditi.
Ma'am, no, it is not important.
Why?
मैम क्योंकि सेम फ्लावर नहीं हो रहा है तो ग्रीन के थ्रू भी हो सकता है
तो क्यों क्यों कलरफुल नहीं है फ्लावर
मैम क्योंकि कलरफुल इसलिए होता है ताकि वो पॉलिनेटिंग एजेंट्स को अट्रैक्ट कर सके फ्लावर सेम है तो अट्रैक्ट करने से
वेरी गुड सो दैट मींस दीज फ्लावर्स दे डू नॉट रिक्वायर एनी अट्रैक्शन ऑफ द पॉलिनेटिंग एजेंट्स because they themselves are sufficient for pollination so that's why they do not require any pollinating agent so they don't have to attract anybody that's why they are not bright in color they are in why flowers are bright in color not for us
to attract the pollinating
animals, biotic pollinating agents. Biotic. It can be insects, it can be birds, it can be rodents, it can be even the primates, lemur. It can be any type of animal. And to attract that, they have to be bright, very brightly colored, and they have to be very fragranceful. The good fragrance should be there. And if they have to attract bees or if they have to attract housefly, then they can be as well.
They need to have nectar.
Dekha na aapne kuch phoolon ki bahut gandi smell hoti hai.
Yes ma'am.
Iske liye hoti hai because they have to attract the houseflies and they have to attract these kind of insects for pollination. So they have whole smell to attract their pollinators. So color of the flower is to attract the pollinator. Similarly, fragrance of the flower is to attract the pollinator. Hai na? Achha. Now we will see what are the different types of pollinating agents. Agents of pollination, divide it into two, abiotic and biotic.
Biotic.
Now in abiotic there are two types of pollinators agents one is wind and second is water wind and water
yes ma'am
out of these two abiotic wind is more common than water So wind pollination is more common than water pollination. Now in wind pollination, what are the requirements? Number one, the pollen should be light because if the pollen is heavy, it cannot go with the wind current. So what are the conditions for wind pollinated pollen? It should be light and non-sticky. Why non-sticky? Why non-sticky?
Non-sticky.
Well, so that it would not attach somewhere else and directly go towards stigma.
Yes, because if it is sticky, it can get stick to anywhere, to any surface. So it is if it is non-sticky and light, it can go with the wind to a large. A longer distance.
Yes, ma'am.
Second requirement is that the stamens should be well exposed. Number two, the stamens should be well exposed. That means the anther lobe should be well out of the flower. If they are inside the flower, the pollen cannot go with the wind. So it should be well exposed. so that it can go out. Third requirement is that the stigma should be large and feathery. Feathery मतलब पंखों के जैसे, ताकि pollen जब उस पे आ जाए तो वो उसको पकड़ ले, उसमें trap हो जाए. The pollen get entrapped inside the feathery structure of stigma. So these are the three conditions which are required for pollination when it is taking place with the help of the wind. Can you give me one example? Very common example where the pollination is.
Maize.
Bhutta. जो भुट्टा आप खाते हैं वो क्या है? उसमें वो जो सुनहरी सुनहरी बाल होते हैं वो क्या है? क्या है?
स्टिग्मा.
नहीं, स्टिग्मा, दैट इज द फेदरी स्टिग्मा.
स्टिग्मा,
वो जो उसके सुनहरी बाल होते हैं वो फेदरी स्टिग्मा है. एंड इनसाइड दैट इट गेट ट्रैप्ड. और जो ओवरी, जो ओवरी है वो कैसी है? विद सिंगल ओव्यूल. Ovary is with single ovule and there are many flowers. So inflorescence is there, many flowers, inflorescence, and then the golden tessels. These are the stigma, feathery stigma. So the most common example of wind pollination is corn cob. Corn cob, bhutta. Wind से होती pollination, grasses, all grasses they pollinate by wind, most of the grasses they pollinate by wind. अच्छा, now suppose the pollen, the flower है, pollen has to go from one flower to another flower by wind. Is there any guarantee that it will reach the stigma? Is there any guarantee?
No, ma'am.
Suppose there are five pollen and they are going by wind. So what will happen?
Two will restrict to the wind.
Will they reach the stigma of the flower?
Ma'am, not all will reach.
Not all, but maybe the not even the one will reach, because there are five. There are only five. But yes, suppose ma'am. There are 5,000.
Then surely some will reach.
That's why the number of pollen produced are enormous. This is another very important question. The number of pollen produced are enormous because there is no guarantee of pollen reaching the stigma with the wind current or water current or with animal. Whatever is the pollinating agent, there is no guarantee. There is no 100% assurance that pollen will reach the stigma. So, the number of pollen produced are always very, very large. So, the question is, the most important question which is being asked is, why the pollen are produced in enormous number? So, what would be the answer? The pollen are in enormous numbers to ensure the pollination. To ensure the pollination. If they are in large numbers, some of them can reach to the stigma. Clear? Now come to the second. Achha, wind mein aapne examples likh liye. Corn cob is there, then grasses are there. Now come to water. Water. Now, very few flowers are pollinated by water. Very few. and mostly monocots. The examples are Vallisneria, Hydrilla.
Zostera
yeah. Is what? It's a marine grass, sea grass. Now what happens, if the pollinating agent is water, what will happen? What is the requirement?
The transfer of male gamete to the female gamete.
But what is the requirement? Kaisa hona chahiye pollen?
Light.
पॉलन कैसा होना चाहिए वाटर में चलने के लिए? द पॉलन शुड बी लाइट द सो दैट इट कैन फ्लोट. नाउ व्हेन द पॉलिनेशन इज अकरिंग बिकॉज ऑफ द वाटर, इट इज अकरिंग इन टू टाइप्स. वन इज वंस द फ्लावर इज आउटसाइड द सरफेस, ठीक है, पानी के सरफेस से ऊपर है फूल, तब कैसा होना चाहिए? तब पॉलन कहां से आएगा? पानी में फ्लोट करके आएगा. एंड इफ द फ्लावर इज सबमर्ज्ड इनसाइड द वॉटर, देन द पॉलन विल अगेन गो बाय स्विमिंग. इट विल गो बाय स्विमिंग एंड रीच द स्टिग्मा. सो स्विमिंग मीन इट विल मूव इन द वॉटर करंट. ये पैसिव, इट इज पैसिव. स्विमिंग मीन्स द पॉलन के पास विंग्स नहीं है, फिन्स नहीं है. वॉट द पॉलन इज डूइंग, इट इज जस्ट पैसिवली गोइंग विद द विंड करंट, सॉरी विद द वॉटर करंट. सो द पॉलन इज गोइंग पैसिवली विद द वॉटर करंट. एंड इट कैन हैपन इन टू टाइप्स. वन इज when the flower is on the surface of the water, for example Vallisneria, and second is when the flower is submerged in the water, and that is example is Zostera, the marine sea grass. Now when the flower is submerged, the pollen can be of ribbon like structure so that it can move freely in the water. Okay, now if the pollen has to remain in the water, so kya hoga, wo gal sakta hai pani mein?
Yes,
so what's the requirement? The pollen should have a protective layer around it so that it can
from
water. And that layer is mucilaginous layer. Write down.
Coming.
The pollen of the water pollinated flowers are protected by mucilaginous layer. Yes. Covering. Mucilaginous covering. Okay. Now the flowers which are pollinated by wind or by pollinated by water, do they should have right or should they have very good fragrance?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
No, kyun?
Because of frost karke ja sakta hai.
Because the pollen is going either by the wind current or by the water current. So they don't have to attract pollinators. That's why these flowers are also white in color. Most of them are white in color, and they do not have any fragrance, and they do not produce any nectar. Write it down. This is also an important question. All flowers pollinated by water or wind do not have any fragrance. They do not have bright colors. The flowers that are pollinated by water or wind do not have bright colored petals. Number one, do not have any good fragrance. They do not produce nectar because there is no need to attract the pollinator. The pollen goes to stigma by wind or water current passively. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Samajh mein aa gaya? Okay. Now let's move to the last thing, which is biotic factor. Pollination by biotic factors. अब बायोटिक फैक्टर्स में क्या क्या हो सकता है बताओ, लिख लो सारे. बर्ड्स, इट कैन बी रोडेंट्स, बैट्स, इंसेक्ट्स, इवन द प्रिमेट्स, द लेम्यूज, दे इवन वी ऑल्सो हेल्प इन द पॉलिनेशन. समटाइम्स यू सिट इन द गार्डन and you like the flower because it is brightly colored flower and the fragrance is very good. So what you do, you pluck the flower and then you start playing with it and then you take the pollens with you and go and sit somewhere else. So you are transferring the pollen from one flower to another. So at times we are also helping in the process of pollination. Now, why do these pollinating agents coming to the flowers? You, why the birds, why the insects, they are coming to the flower?
Because of attraction.
Because of attraction, but what do they want from flower? Only attraction?
Ma'am, bees take nectar and...
Very good. So, either they are coming to drink nectar... Or they are coming to eat pollen. Right?
They have place for insects to lay eggs.
Or they are coming to lay eggs inside the flower.
Yes.
So, kyun aa rahe hai? Why are they coming? They are coming for their own benefit. They are not coming for pollination. They are coming, number one, to drink nectar. To eat pollen. And number three, the birds and everything, animals are coming to lay their eggs. For example, there is example of yucca plant and moth. So moth comes to lay their eggs. Agar yucca plant is not there, the moth will not lay its eggs. So these are called rewards, floral rewards. Inko kya bolte hai? Floral rewards. These are the rewards which the pollinators are getting when they are coming to the flowers. Either they are getting nectar or they are getting pollens or they are getting space to lay their eggs. So these are called rewards. Isko kya bolte hai? Rewards. Floral rewards. Now suppose insect comes and drinks the nectar but do not take the pollen from one flower to another. So usko kya bolenge?
Ma'am, pollen robber.
Usko kya bolenge? Chor. So that
are
thieves. Robbers.
Robbers.
They are nectar robbers. जो नेक्टर तो पी लेते हैं पर पॉलिनेशन नहीं करते. तो दे आर कॉल्ड नेक्टर रॉबर्स और दे आर कॉल्ड पॉलन रॉबर्स. दे आर कॉल्ड रॉबर्स. दीज आर ऑल इंपॉर्टेंट टर्म्स यू शुड नो. रॉबर्स, द फ्लोरल रिवॉर्ड्स. दे आर कॉल्ड पॉलन रॉबर्स. देयर इज द टॉलेस्ट फ्लावर which is called Amorphophallus. It's in your NCERT book. Amorphophallus. This is 6 feet in height. This flower is 6 feet in height. And in this flower, the birds come to lay their eggs. And there is another flower which is called yucca. In yucca plant, the moth comes to lay its eggs. So this is called yucca, yucca and moth. They are also living in symbiosis. साथ में रहते हैं. अगर यक्का प्लांट नहीं होगा तो मौत को जगह नहीं मिलती अपने एग्स रिलीज करने के लिए. ये कौन सा फ्लावर है बताओ? What is this?
Wind pollinated plant.
Very good. अच्छा ये देखो. This is insect. And this is insect pollination.
Ma'am, it is carrying a pollen grain.
Huh?
It is carrying pollen grain. Bee.
Yeah. This insect is carrying pollen. Okay, and this is what? This is water pollinated. Which plant is this? Vallisneria. The flower is here, and this is the main flower. The pollens are set, and they will reach at the surface of the water to pollinate the flower. Now, today, what all we have done? Pollination. Three types of pollination.
Yes, ma'am.
What are the three types of pollination?
Autogamy, heterogamy, and xenogamy.
Very good. And what are the pollinating agents?
Biotic and abiotic agents.
Abiotic and biotic. Abiotic are major two agents. What are these two?
Wind and water.
Wind and water. Which is more common?
Wind.
Wind is more common. Very good. And what are the conditions required for a flower to be wind pollinated?
Non-sticky.
Second,
stamen is well exposed.
Stamen should be large and exposed. Third,
well exposed. And ma'am, feathery. Stamen should be feathery.
Long and feathery stigma. And what are the conditions which are required for the water pollinated flower?
Pollen should be light.
There are two conditions. One, when the flower is present after the surface, on the above the surface of the water, and second is when the flower is submerged. So in both the conditions, the pollen is reaching the stigma passively by the water current. So in that case, the pollen should have a protective covering, and that protective covering is of mucilaginous. So it is a mucilaginous covering. Okay. Now the in biotic factor, they can be insects, they can be birds, animals, human beings. Everybody can be pollinating agents, and they are going to be. Why they are going towards the flower? Because of their bright color.
Attraction.
So bright color of flower is to attract the pollinating agents, biotic pollinating agents, and nectar and the fragrance. ठीक है?